Naj, and before I start, pronounce first and last name, because I've screwed up people's lives in the past by doing a podcast, and then people come up and mispronounce your name to you.
It's funny you say it. It's Naj Qureshi.
Okay, got it.
So it's not the first time.
I probably would have gotten it.
Yeah.
But yeah, so
I get it a lot.
Yeah, no, I'm sure. But I have it, and even when I think I know, I've like Katie Thoreau versus Katie Theroux. I got it right, but I've made the mistake, and then it messes them, because people will come up at shows or whatever because they heard the.
It's funny you say that. I mean, having a name like this, I mean, you get used to it after a while, but yeah. Flying's always fun. Flying is always fun for me. I don't understand how it's random extra security if it happens every time you fly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh man, well it's good to see you, and we're here at ISB 2019, and you're here with a whole bunch of instruments.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely. So I decided to start Ottava a couple years ago. I was in Italy on a vacation, and I was like, you know, I want to meet with some of these Italian makers and see what they have. So, you know, it's not some of the bigger name guys that I know. They're kind of off the beaten track, mm-hmm. but they make these quality instruments. Mm-hmm. You know, they're fantastic. You know, nothing's mass produced. You know, nothing's made in other countries and, you know, stamped with the Italian label on it. They have no apprentices, no helpers. So really, they're doing self guys.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
One man shows. So, you know, I had the idea. I said, you know, they want to bring their basses to America. You know, I want to, you know, put Italian instruments in the hands of young bass players, mm-hmm. at a great cost.
Yep.
You know, the quality we have, you know, I haven't seen it anywhere. You know, and my goal first and foremost, you know, not really as a businessman, you know, honestly, you know, I'm in a few businesses with my dad, mm-hmm. you know, for a job, but my passion's always been bass. You know, I'm a bass player at heart. So when I saw these instruments, you know, a kind of light bulb went off that, you know, hey, you know, we can market this.
When did you get started with all this?
So it's been 2 years. I started bringing instruments in 2 years ago. But the problem is, as you know, living in Virginia, the climate, you know, coming to Virginia compared to Italy.
Yeah.
So, you know, I brought them in and, you know, honestly took the hit and let them sit in my house. Mm-hmm. For a long time, just to, you know, gauge the expanding and contracting, because I, you know, last thing I want to do is, you know, sell somebody on the quality of this instrument,
right,
and then have it like blow up in their hands,
right.
So, you know, I go through at least one full cycle of a winter,
mm-hmm.
And then once it's you know, been through a winter, we evaluate it and we get it set up, and you know, we bring it to market in the summer. But this has been a long process in the making. This is kind of my grand opening this week.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've done some private showings, you know, for some friends. You know, I live in D.C., so around the D.C. area, you know, the NSO guys and, you know, some of the schools say, hey, you know, what do you guys think? Just to get some feedback. But, you know, really, it's just been a long process to bring everything to fruition this week.
And you've got Brett Edmondson and Amanda Rice Johnson. Brett's been on the podcast, and Amanda, I got to track her down. I got to steal her away from you for a few minutes to chat about her career.
Oh, absolutely.
So they're here, and they've been playing these basses.
Oh, it's really funny. They've been playing these basses, but you know, Brent has been not only just a fantastic friend, but he played the Koussevitzky Concerto with Lancaster Symphony in Pennsylvania. You know, I want to say a couple months now. You blink an eye and it's 2 months.
Right.
So, but he had his personal bass in solo tuning and didn't want to screw around with the tuning. So he asked if he could borrow an instrument. And in fact, the instrument he borrowed from me, he got to the finals of an audition with it. So when he chalked it up, you know, don't get me wrong, Brent is one of the most talented bass players I know. But he chalked part of it up to the instrument. So Brent has been kind of an advocate for me, you know, trying to get these things into the right people's hands.
There are a lot of talented luthiers in Italy, and a lot of talented, you know, people that are not maybe on the radar the way that some
of these guys, you know, they're on the radar in Europe, but they're on nobody's radar in the States.
Yeah.
And you know, there's some of them that I have agreements with that, you know, they only sell their instruments through me in the mm-hmm. States. So, you know, it's kind of a big opportunity, kind of a big deal.
Yeah. And the stability, so you let him sit, and the stability, they seem to make the
There's
transition.
minor movements.
And that's just what always happens.
Yeah. And you know, some of these instruments, you know, there's some stories, you know, like one of them is made from 250-year-old wood, but wasn't made into a bass until 2000.
Wow.
You know, one of the luthiers found this antique armoire in Italy and said, you know, it's 250-year-old wood, it's been aged. And he disassembled it, broke it down, and made it into a bass.
Wow.
And it sounds like an old instrument, but you play it and you have the maintenance of a modern instrument in your hands.
It's great.
And this is all verified through third parties, so it's not just me saying, hey, you know, it's really old wood, you know, but then you chip it and it's white.
You think about Italy and all that great tradition of instrument. It makes sense that there's a lot of wood like that.
Oh yeah, I mean, they live for the finding these gems of like old antiques, armoires and stuff. And these guys are master woodworkers, and so they know how to handle it.
Yeah, for sure.
But I mean, I got to be honest, it doesn't suck. I get to go to Italy now every summer for 2 weeks.
There's nothing wrong with that. I was there for the Bass Europe last summer, and of course, it ended up being a massive heat wave in Europe. So I was sweating a little more than you might normally be.
I was there 3 weeks before Bass Europe, but it's funny you mentioned Bass Europe. One of the actually two of the makers that won prizes at Lucca, I'm showing two of their instruments. Actually, one of them was a prize winner in Lucca, Roberto Salvianti. One for the tone competition and the audience favorite, and that bass is in our booth right now. It's the response to it in America has been fantastic. And Cristiano Scipioni, he made a bass for me too that actually Dan Stife just played a great recital with, and we're selling that bass, you know, at Ottava.
Yeah, I've been listening to those basses throughout the week, and it's great. I gotta stop by, leave my booth here, and come across the hall and try out some of these instruments.
Oh, it's fantastic! Yeah. The response has been really great. You know, I feel like it's almost overwhelming. You know, I feel like a kid in a candy shop as a bass player. You know, I'm sandwiched between Guarneri House and Robertson, so you know, it's like I'm bombarded with sound.
Yeah.
But you know, I think my guys are my basses are holding their own. It's funny, you know, we haven't really sold any basses yet. However, we've been second place like three times already.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I say, you know, coming out of the gates for people not knowing who I am and you know what we're all about, I take that as an amazing win.
Yeah, yeah, it's all about getting on people's radar and getting the word out, and this. Word of mouth is a powerful thing. Yeah.
Well, you know, I think one thing that we're doing a little differently, you know, not to selfishly plug OttavaImports.com, but what we're doing is I believe in a standard of quality. All my instruments, I don't say one's better than the other, so they're all priced exactly the same.
Mm.
So you know, there's a standard I have. I won't sell anything that I wouldn't play or buy myself as a bass player. I mean, that's first and foremost. Like I said, you know, don't get me wrong, I turn a little bit of a profit, but I'm not really in it for the money. You know, I'm in it to help the younger guys. You know, because face it, you know, growing up, you know, as a bassist in, you know, back in the 1900s, that there really wasn't a whole lot, like especially where I lived. You know, I lived in the D.C. area, and it was like, you know, you had the George Vance camp, you know, and we all, you know, we're students of, you know, Vance in one way or another.
Mm-hmm.
But there really wasn't a whole lot. And now, you know, as we're growing, you know, in size, bass players I'm talking, you got, you know, Donovan Stoats has a great camp. You have D.C. Bass with, you know, Danola and Ira. You have, you know, Peabody Bass Works. So, you know, as these things are, you know, coming up and we're taking care of the younger guys, you know, I think they deserve to have, you know, a shot at some of these great, great instruments.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's cool. I love the concept of pricing them all the same and not playing on something that you wouldn't want to be.
Yeah.
Honestly,
it's, you know, I feel like sometimes, you know, there's a lot of people that will like put a hard sell on something.
Yep.
And really, like, my approach is just laid back. It's like, look, you know, they're all the same. I would be flattered to have them. In fact, I secretly hope and tell my wife, you know, let's hope they don't sell so I have this wonderful collection of basses. And she's like, I'm telling you, if you don't come home with less than you go with, then, you know, we're going to have a different chat.
Yeah.
So, but
that's
but,
the goal.
But yeah. I mean, she's been so supportive. She believes in this as well. So, you know, I don't think we can, I mean, I don't think we can lose.
Well, Naj, hope that this is the first of many sightings at trade shows like ISB and other events like that. And so OttavaImports.com.
Yep. OttavaImports.com. And, you know, our full gallery is there of instruments, but, you know, we'll gladly come out to you guys and, you know, your sections wherever within reason. Just let us know. Just give us enough warning and, you know, we'll be there.
Sounds great.
Cool.
Pleasure.
Man. Absolutely. All right.